Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. And today we are going to make another fun art and craft. Actually, I'm just kidding, no art and craft today, because today we'll be doing some fun experiments. I'll be doing 3 experiments today, which are totally fun, and I guess you have everything for it at home. And if you don't have, maybe you can do it without it, or it is also you can buy it anyways, like everywhere, like in station shops and stuff. Maybe you can take it from your mother. Okay, so let's start. So today the the thing we're gonna need for all our experiments are a glass. You know, you want a transparent glass, okay, with water, at least this much water you need on the in the glass. Then you want a steel glass as well, which also has water in it. Okay, then you're gonna need some vinegar, some nice vinegar. Need some oil. Can take vegetable oil also, some baking soda, and one empty bowl or glass. If you have a lot of vinegar, like a lot, like this much vinegar at least, you can use a glass. But right now I'm only have a little vinegar, so I'll be using a bowl. So let's start. So the first I'm gonna do the paper clip hack. First you're gonna need a steel glass bottle for these stuff. Oh yeah, and I forgot to tell you, you need paper clips and glitter. Yeah, I forgot to tell you that. Sorry. Okay, so for the paper, so my first experiment is the paper clip experiment. Yeah. So first let me show you. Can you put a paper clip on a glass? No, it just sank. So I need to take it now. Oopsies. 1 second. Okay. So let it be there. Now, let me. So what you basically have to do now, you can handle it with one simple thing. How to handle a paper clip? First, take one paper clip. Okay, you guys can see it normally. Can you see the big part and then there's a small part? Take the big part and make it like bent it like this, like so. It's supposed to look like this. And then what you do, you have to put a paper clip on it. 1 second. Yeah, put a paper clip on it. Very careful, you have to on off the fan. If you have the fan on now, you have to off the fan. Okay, so when I'm done bending, okay, now you have to like take it carefully and put it like very carefully. Sorry, I'm a little clumsy, so don't pay attention to that. Very clumsy, but for this you can't be clumsy. Be really careful. Okay, this is how you put it. Then you have to put it on the surface of the water. Oopsies, sorry guys. There's been a technical issue. Sorry. Come out. Sorry. Yeah. So actually I'm a little clumsy, and that's why my friend is going to do it for me. Yep. So guys, look at that. And there you have it, guys. My friend did it. She's my sister friend. Oopsies, it sank. If you shake the glass too much, it sinks. So yeah, that's it. So that's my first hack. So yeah, that was my hack. Yes, that was mine, and so that was my first experiment. I hope you guys liked it. So you have to be very careful, and if your friend or your sister or brother or your mother or your father or anything person is way more better than you on not being clumsy, then make that person do that, because if you're gonna need a lot of patience for this, which I do not have, so don't blame me. I don't have patience a lot. My friend does have a lot, and my friend is only filming this. Okay, so my next experiment, I'm going to be doing a floating candle. You might have heard about this a lot, and this will be a perfect hack for your parents, because for Diwali or Christmas or like that, you can use it in the night. So it's very easy. You're going to need a glass. This kind of glass. You need a transparent one which you can see things in. You can't take a steel glass; that won't work. I mean, would, but you need to see it, right? So, for that, I've already have water. I'm gonna take some oil, okay? Okay, and you can, if you want your water to be colored, you can put some paint in it, but I won't put any paint. okay, and you have to first take the water and then put it in, then put oil, not first, okay? So put some oil. So as you know, oil doesn't get mixed with it. So guys, let me show you from here side. Can you see those big bubbles? Can you see a layer of oil right here? See it? It's very thin, but I know this part layer. You see it? It's very nice. It's very thin. You guys can use a little more oil. A little oil. Okay. Now I'm gonna use glitter. Glitter in. Ugh, squeeze. Start. So yeah, this is how you're gonna do. Yep, glitter is coming out. You guys can also use powdered glitter. That'll be a way better option than what we are using right now, liquid glitter. Yeah, let me just, yeah. So it's looking a little weird. You guys have to use the powder glitter only. So it's not looking so nice. But, and then you have to like, you can also put paint on the oil maybe. Maybe it'll create one more layer. I've not tried that yet. Okay, so, and guys, I need to tell you something really cool. You can take those electric those candles which have those buttons now. You can put them on that, this glass, and then it'll become actually a floating candle, and then you can put it on the light, and then boom, shakalaka. Sorry, but I like to say those words. So yeah, then that floating candle will be perfect. So can you see you can see the glitter oil layer. Looks amazing. Looks like some magical world. So yeah. So for my next and my favorite, me and my sister's favorite experiment, the explosion one. So I'm really happy for this one. I hope this turns out really good. I really want this to turn out good. I've heard about this. I've never tried it. I wanted to try it with you guys. So yeah. So we're gonna take our vinegar. We're gonna take our vinegar and some baking soda. So yeah, some baking soda and some vinegar. I can even show you how big katoris I've taken. I mean bowls, but katoris, sorry. Okay, then I'm gonna put some vinegar in this. So you guys, you have to put first baking soda, actually not vinegar, sorry. And if you guys notice, I'm actually sitting on a different table this time. And you guys, actually why? Because my basic table is, I'm okay to use that, but what is happening now? Because this explosion experiment is going to be a little, it just says in the name, explosion. It's called volcanoes also, but I'm not going to use volcanoes for it. I'm not going to make any volcanoes. But that's why I'm sitting near the balcony, so all the explosions can go out of the balcony. So like, yeah, that's why I'm using it. So my friend's going a little far away because she doesn't want any explosion to get in. So that's why. So guys, I'm taking this whisk for you. So put it really far away. So guys, you need to comment down below, which shall I use, this or this? I think I'm going to use this one. Or shall I use this one? I'm doing this. Vinegar. Baking soda first. This. Guys, there was a little vinegar left in this, and look, I could hear sizzling. Oh, guys, I'm scared. Oh, guys, look at that! I shouldn't go far away. So guys, look at the sizzling. Whoa! Explosion in the house. Whoa, guys, that was amazing. Let's put some more water and see what happens. Nope. I'm gonna try to put some water in this. Whoa, guys, it just floated. Let's try mixing it. Yep, this is what happened. So that explosion was awesome. You guys can try this at home. Thank God I'm sitting near the balcony. I'm happy for that. You guys, this
experiment was amazing. It's too amazing. I loved it. So, oopsies, sorry. So, guys, you guys can also try these experiments at your home. And I hope you liked my video. So subscribe to my channel if you're new. And like and subscribe. Hey, come on. Even my friend has her hand here today. So, bye, guys. Love you.